So today let me discuss about magnetic force. Okay, what is magnetic force? If there is a magnetic field, let's say there is a magnetic field in this region of space, and a charged particle is moving in that, within that magnetic field. Charged particle, let's say Q is the charged particle, it's moving, that means it has a velocity. At this point the velocity is along the tangent of that, of its trajectory, velocity is V. If it is moving in that magnetic field, then the magnetic force, all of you know, is given by the, or it is called Lorentz force. That is the formula for calculating the magnetic force on that charged particle by that magnetic field is given by Q into V cross B. V cross B. Q into V cross B. That means if the charged particle, if the particle is not a charged particle, it moves inside the magnetic field, that means Q is zero. If Q is zero, magnetic force is zero. If the charged particle is not moving, if it is static, that means V is zero, then also magnetic force is zero. And if there is no magnetic field and the charged particle is moving, then also there is no magnetic force. Okay. And also if the charged particle is moving perpendicular to the magnetic field, then also the magnetic force is zero. So these are the four conditions under which magnetic force can be equal to zero. The particle has to be a charged particle, particle needs to have a velocity, there needs to have a magnetic field, non-zero magnetic field, and the velocity of the particle has to be non-perpendicular to the magnetic field. Okay. Now in this section I want to calculate the magnetic force on a segment of current carrying wire. So let's say this is a wire which is carrying a steady current I, and this wire is kept in a magnetic field B. I want to calculate the magnetic force that will be acted on this current carrying wire segment. Okay. So the idea is very simple, the same formula I will be using. So let's say this is this DL element I am choosing this DL element of this current loop. That means the magnetic force will be what? Will be Q into V cross B. Q means the charge that is inside this small segment. Let's call it DQ. DQ into V cross B. Let's say the charged particles have velocity V cross B. Okay. And we want to calculate the total magnetic force on this current segment. That means I need to do this integration over the whole wire. Okay. Now what is this DQ? DQ means if lambda is the line charge density, then DQ can be written as lambda DL into V cross B integration. Now please understand this fact, that if I write down lambda into V, what does it mean? Lambda means per unit length there is lambda amount of charge in that wire. And what is V? V is the velocity of that charge, of those charged particles. That means V is the distance that those charges will be covering per unit time. So V into lambda, that will be total amount of charge that will be covered per unit time, total amount of distance that those charges will be covering per unit time. That means lambda into V. So if I write it like this, lambda V cross B, lambda into V is nothing but the I. Okay. Lambda into V is I. Let me put a vector sign on this current. Okay. Lambda into V. Now you can understand that the direction of current and the direction of DL vector, if I call it a vector, direction of current and direction of DL vector will be same. So I can just interchange the vector sign. So DL cross B, I can write it like this, I DL cross B. I have just interchanged the vector sign from the current to DL, because both of them has the same direction. Okay, I DL cross B, so result will not change. Now if you have a steady if you have a steady current, steady current means I does not change over the whole current segment. That means I can come out of this integration, I integration dl cross b. Okay, now if you have a uniform magnetic field, then this b will also be going out of this integration sign. So I can write it like I dl cross b. Okay, so this is the expression of magnetic force on a current segment. Okay, I will be using this result. The final result is for steady current and uniform magnetic field. If the current is not steady, then this will be the result. I dl cross b, integration dl cross b. Current is, so this will be the result. If the current is not steady and you don't know about the magnetic field is not uniform. If the magnetic field is not uniform, so this is the result. And if the current is steady and magnetic field is uniform, this will be the result. I will be applying this result in the next video. I will be applying this result to define something called magnetic vector, magnetic dipole moment. That will be very important for you to understand.